pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Taking a deep breath, and as you breathe out, feel your body begin to relax. Listen to the sounds around you. Just observe what you can hear. Perhaps a car passing by, birds singing in the trees outside. Maybe you can hear the creaking of the building. Just notice. Listen to the sounds around you. And with every sound that you hear, you become more and more relaxed, slipping deeper and deeper down, deeper and deeper down, more and more relaxed. With every sound that you notice, just notice and observe all of the subtle sounds around you as you are still, peaceful, quiet, and centered. You are still, peaceful, and quiet. Turn your attention inside your body now. See if you can hear the beating of your heart. If you are quiet enough and still enough, you can actually hear and feel the beating of your heart. Feel the energy flowing around your body, renewing, relaxing, nurturing and healing every cell within you with the beating of your heart. Now, when you are ready, take in a deep breath. And as you breathe out, have a gentle stretch. Whatever feels comfortable for you right now, just like a cat waking up in the morning, you are feeling energized, confident, and deeply relaxed, ready to enjoy a beautiful, wonderful day.
Elaborate sets, laughter, family fun, awe, and amazement. Circuses are the things of dreams, but not for the animals. As you sit in the stands of the circus, watching the bears, elephants, and tigers, oh my, perform these impossible tricks, you can't help but be impressed. But how are they trained to be able to walk those tight ropes, balance on those tiny balls, ride those bicycles, or jump through those rings of fire? Through fear and abuse. Circus elephants are often trained with bull hooks. Trainers use the sharp part to prod sensitive areas of the elephant's body and the handle to strike them. Circus lions and tigers are beaten, starved, and confined for long periods of time until they're willing to cooperate, according to Big Cat Rescue. When they're not on stage, circus animals can spend anywhere from 75 to 99% of their lives in chains or cages. And their travel lives are no better. 11 months out of 12, they spend traveling grueling distances in small boxcars. The car has no climate control, and they are forced to eat, sleep, and defecate in the same place. Animals that are inherently social, now doomed to a life of isolation. animals that need space to move are now forced into cramped conditions. And when they aren't able to exercise or move like they naturally should, illnesses and injuries come calling. All the while, the circus puts out an image of using only positive reinforcement on their animals. And sure, it may look like that during the show, but they never let you see what goes on behind those closed curtains. There is a government agency with the authority to review how these animals are cared for, or uncared for. But it has more than 8,000 facilities to inspect annually, including zoos, circuses, etc. And to take on this crazy large list, there are only a little over 100 inspectors. So you can imagine how easy it is for them to enforce these laws, let alone visit all these places. These animals belong in the wild, free to do what they do best. Be wild. They don't deserve to be doomed to a life of pain and misery at the hands of entertaining our kids. Seriously, that's what the internet is for. Or if you really want to go to a circus, go to Cirque du Soleil. They don't use animals in their shows.